There's no real athlete without a proper meal plan on his mind, and at least some general knowledge on how nutrition works. We all know that it's the food that makes the muscles grow. But there's a lot of controversy out there, which makes it quite easy to get confused. In part, because of inconclusive results shown by the studies on the topic of nutrition. Also, partially because people who found success with their nutrition plan believe it to be the plan, which simply has to work for everyone. That, of course, isn't necessarily true. Hi, and welcome to Alpha Territory. We are more than a clothing brand, and we believe in making a positive change towards your goal-chasing journey. We strive to provide you with the most reliable and accurate resources so you can push further and achieve any fitness goal. What we want to achieve in this video is to give our advice, based on experience and thorough research, on how you should plan your nutrition game. In order to do so, we've decided to split the topic into three main categories. 1. Counting meals. 2. Nutrition intake. And 3. Protein absorption. Counting your meals. So, let's start with the basics. The first question we want to answer is how many times a day should you eat? And, to be honest, the answer is somewhere between 1 and 7, in some extreme cases. It mostly depends on who asks, his or her size, current weight, goals, metabolism, etc. But since we're making estimates for an average person, let's say that the optimal number of meals you should eat per day is anywhere between 3 and 5. If your caloric intake needs to be higher, you'll have 5 bigger meals. If you need to lower it down a notch, just lower the calories per meal or skip a meal altogether. The reason why we want this number of meals and not some other has to do with the time gaps during which your body uses up the nutrients you've taken and repairs your muscle tissue. If you have 5 meals per day, that means you will have a meal every 3 hours or so. That is great because protein and other macronutrients require time to be absorbed once they enter the bloodstream. Furthermore, both protein intake alone and in a mixture with other macros does change things significantly. Not all food goes directly to your bloodstream immediately after you eat. Some foods are processed quicker and others need time. This is also why you want to eat certain foods before your workouts, certain foods before bedtime, and so forth. If you eat something too heavy for your stomach right before you go to the gym, you risk having a dull or inefficient workout because your body will be focused on digesting the huge amounts of nutrients which you've just had. Try to avoid making mistakes such as these when planning your daily nutrition. Nutrient intake. Nutrient intake depends on the food source, and it varies heavily. Sometimes this process can take several hours, and sometimes it can take only a couple of minutes. For example, certain proteins have a relatively fast release, for example, whey protein, while others need more time, like casein. The pattern of eating every 3 to 4 hours optimizes the nutrient absorption process and is thus a strong reason why your meals should be spread out during your waking hours rather than compressed into one or a few big meals. It might sound difficult to eat so many meals per day. It takes some getting used to. However, there are methods you can apply to make your life easier while trying to achieve your fitness goals. One of the things you can do is to prepare your food in advance. Sacrifice a little bit of your time today and make food for tomorrow. This way you can save a bunch of time. Protein absorption. Lastly comes protein absorption. The last reason why you should have about 5 meals per day is that your body might be lacking protein if you decide to settle for 1 or maybe 2 meals per day. Now, this is a very sensitive topic in the fitness industry, so we do need to take extra caution. In general, there is no real barrier past which your body will simply stop taking the protein, especially if you fast and eat only 1 meal per day. Rather, what we're trying to say is that it is most efficient to have your protein intake spread out through the day. Imagine this scenario. Let's say your body needs about 200 grams of protein if you wish to recover from your workouts and put on some muscle mass. It is way easier for someone who wants that many grams of protein every day to simply take 5 meals, in which he divides the macros equally, than to have one meal after which he'll be tied to the bed for the rest of the day. Don't know how much protein you need? There is a rule of thumb you can use to see what the optimal protein per meal should be for you. Once again, this equation is apt for the average person. You might not fit in that category, so pay attention when you're counting the macros you need if you want to perfect your diet. According to a study conducted by the Journal of the International Society of Sports Nutrition, in which they cite a text from Moore and others, they found a number of 0.4 grams of protein per kilogram of body weight. If you weigh 180 pounds, that means you should intake about 32 grams of protein per meal. Obviously, the number will tilt if your workouts are extremely demanding, or if you want to achieve some different goal. Like always, there are exceptions to every rule. A couple of more things to be said. Calculating your macros down to the exact number is not an easy task by any means. If you are professional, you will need to do it since every gram is important at the competition level. But if you aren't, settling for an approximate number of macros will be just fine. You only have to make sure you are on the right side of the macro intake. A tiny reminder, don't build your diet solely around protein. This is a common mistake nowadays. There is added protein in almost everything you can find on the counter. From chocolate bars to chips, you can find added protein almost everywhere. Truth is, having a surplus of protein is by no means a hack, and it will not help you achieve the perfect body. Having a well-balanced amount of protein, fats, and carbs in your diet is the right way to go. Without it, you won't make much progress. Do not forget the importance of vitamins, minerals, fatty oils, and others. They too play an important role in any sports diet. Thanks for watching. If you're new to our channel, feel free to subscribe and check out our website in the description to learn more about our mission and vision. More than just subscribers, we're creating a pack community. We'll see you again for our next video. Be bold and stay alpha.